Hey guys, welcome back. There's nothing I enjoy more than a good fail, because it makes me feel better about my own self. I think the funny part about that joke is the fact that it's true. It's not even really a joke, it's just facts. Now, I pride myself on being able to flirt over text messaging. I feel like that's one of the things I do best in the world. That is to say, I don't have many talents otherwise, and this is just one of the few things I do okay. So that gives me the opportunity to look down on people. So let's look down on some people who said some stupid stuff. How do you want it, baby? Shirtless picture. Kinda want those Pop-Tarts. Wow, Eagle Eye over here fucking spotted the Pop-Tarts from a mile away. What I wanna focus on here is the fact that I don't know when this person sent the picture, but the person responded at 12:50 p.m. So that's 12:50 in the afternoon. Who sends shirtless pictures in the morning? Nobody should be doing that. Also, I know why this picture is cropped. It's not so that he can keep his anonymity. It's to hide the fact that he's scrunching his face because he's flexing so hard. Like, he's got the camera and he's like... One more. Got it. How do you want it, baby? I want a picture for my birthday. Guy sends a picture of his face. Happy birthday. Of you naked. Guy sends another picture naked, but it's only his face. Below the belt. Okay, and this is where it gets clever. He sends a picture holding up a belt. What I want to know is how that belt has such a lateral, like, wouldn't it dangle? How did this guy do it? Look at the sag. Look at the sag on the belt. Okay, bro, I know your tricks. You hold it from the side. I was thinking you were some sort of fucking wizard. Nope, you're just good with belts. Are you a monster in bed, winky face? I don't like to brag, but... That's a picture of Clef from Monsters, Inc. I don't know his real name, but I feel like it's something similar to Clef. This picture actually makes me cringe, though, because there's pizza directly on the sheets, and that's gonna stain. That's gonna be a problem. Even that tipped over can, that's a problem for me. How do you sleep like that? How do you sleep with pizza right next to you? You wake up with sauce all over yourself. I wanna see you. Go on my Instagram. Whoever responded, go on my Instagram. I wanna be friends with you, because that is so genius. Night. Don't spell night like that. Don't do it. You're gonna be tempted to shave one letter off, but don't do it. Love you. Love you too in bed now. Send me a dirty pic. Need inspiration. And Ice Sarah sends back a picture of a dirty bowl. Oh, see, this is the kind of person I don't want to be friends with. I hate dirty dishes. And now that's just in our text thread forever. That's just gonna be there. Every time I wanna scroll up, I'm gonna have to see that. God damn it, Sarah. You home? Yee. I wanna be friends with this guy now. Yee. It's not yes. It's not yeah. It's just yee. Can I have the thing? The thing? But all this person wanted was the history notes. How sad is that? Send me a dirty pic. My dirty sink. Get the... What are you doing? Laying in my bed? Naked? Yes. Show me. It's dark. I don't care. Black picture. Yo! Sup. 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 I mean, dude is committed. I mean, over a 3-month span, July, September, August, October, over a 4-month span, he said sup 7 times with no response. And if I could draw your attention to the bottom of this picture, looks like December 11th, he sent another message. I appreciate your commitment to saying what's up to people, but I think at a certain point you just gotta take the hint, bro. Just to warn you, I'm returning pretty sunburned. Promise not to make fun of me too much. Hey, sorry to do this, but I kinda randomly met someone yesterday separate from OkCupid. We hit it off and I kinda wanna see where it goes. No worries, thanks for letting me know and good luck. What do you mean you randomly met someone on OkCupid? You go there to meet somebody, so it's not random. But I really, really feel so bad for the person that texted this, because they texted them back after some sort of vacation, and they're like, haha, please don't make fun of me, haha, we have our inside thing. And the other person's like, ah, got someone new. So the first person can only be like, yeah, no. It's not like I was thinking about you while vacation and couldn't wait to get back and text you. And it's not like I've been thinking about that message for days. No. I wish you all the best. Yeah, that person that you met, they're probably better than me anyways. It's fine. Good luck. Thank you again for an amazing first date, smiley face. Anytime, winky face. When's the second date? I can't wait to see those big, beautiful nipples of yours. No! I'm so sorry, I meant dimples. My phone changed it. I did not mean to write nipples. If I was the guy, I would've let it ride. Just go with the nipples, and then if she's like, ooh, really? Then you're in. But if she's like, oh, what the hell? You're like, oh no, I'm so sorry, autocorrect. You played your cards too soon there, my friend. You should've held on to them with the autocorrect excuse, so that if she's not receptive to the nipple thing, you could be like, oh, autocorrect. Here you go. See? That's not what I meant. But if she's into the nipple thing, then you could be like, that's what I meant the whole time. I would really appreciate it if you would stop texting my girlfriend. I would really appreciate it if you would stop cock-licking me. Blocking, I mean. Again, another autocorrect. Let it ride, baby. That way, if the guy texts back something like, what? You can be like, you heard me. Just really create this person out so that they don't want to fuck with you. November 24th, happy Thanksgiving. December 14th, what's up, cute stuff? December 25th, hey, I know you're up and unwrapping awesome gifts. A very Merry Christmas to you and yours, Chris. December 28th, hey, how was your holiday? Chris is just the worst kind of texter. He's the person that texts you when it's holidays, trying to get in with you. You know, he's trying to like start a conversation using the holiday as a reason to text you. But you don't want to talk to Chris. You really don't. I guarantee you, if this picture was bigger, there's a text on the 31st saying, hey, happy New Year's Eve, we got plans. And then a subsequent one on the 1st that says, hey, happy New Year's Day. How was your New Year's? Did you get drunk? Chris just knows this is a failed gambit. It's not gonna work. How do I know this? Because he literally puts his name at the end of a text message. You must think that there's a chance that they don't have you saved as a contact, that you're just a number. That's embarrassing, Chris. Chris, give it up. How do I tell Chris I like him, though? These things are hard. You just did, Ellie, winky face. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. That was to Jenna. Her name isn't even close to mine, though. Did you send this on purpose to me? Don't worry if you did, winky face. Maybe. Winky face. What's up with these people? I hope they don't get together, because this is too many winky faces for one short interaction. Does that mean that you like me too? No. Period. Come on, Ellie. You gotta be more subtle than this. Jenna, Chris, there's too many letters in between. You gotta go by the one letter rule. If the name starts with like a B, you can go A or C, but you can't go D. There are rules to the game, Ellie. Learn to play. That's why you get rejected, because you don't know the fucking rules. Did you get my Snapchat? What was it? My dick. Oh, I thought it was your thumb. Oh yeah, it does kind of look like a penis. Same size too. Good afternoon, beautiful. No. I'm gonna be honest, man. I'm glad this person got rejected, because that's too blunt of a compliment. You can't just from the jump start throwing compliments on the other person. Good afternoon, beautiful. Like, how you doing, gorgeous? Stop.
Stop it. Get some help.
You can't just swoop in with the compliments, man. You gotta be smoother. You gotta just kind of slide them in when they don't expect them. Send me a pic of surprise me. How dare you ruin Ariana Grande's beautiful, beautiful head. Ow! I'm disgusted. She looks like an uncle. I like you. Do you like me? No. Sad face. You never asked me if I loved you. Aw, do you love me? No. What I like so much about this one is you got the roller coaster going, man. Do you like me? Hopes up? No. We're at a real low here, but you never asked me if I loved you. Aw, the hopes are going back up.
No.
Want to hang out tonight? What time? Anytime. I'm free whenever. I'm going to invite you to a group setting because I don't ever want to be alone with you and give you the idea that I would ever date you. Haha. Why not just say like, yes, but I only see you as a friend. Are you cool with that? Instead, she's got to go for the jugular by saying, I don't want to be alone with you. Friends can be alone with each other. What the hell, Mindy? And give you the idea that I would ever date you. So not only am I not interested in you, but I'm so uninterested that there is nothing that you could ever do that I would ever be interested in you. Someone sends a picture of their dick on a toilet. Double gross. You like? Not even a question mark. You like? They got the banana cutter. Seems like it would be about the right size. Undeterred, they send I shouldn't say deterred because they're on the toilet. They send a second dick pic. How about this one? Person sends a picture of them cutting meat. Wow, bye. Yeah, they're the one that you need to run away from, not the person sending two unsolicited dick pics. Hey, message me back when you can. I have a boyfriend. Congratulations. Which part of the PowerPoint should I do? I feel like I know this girl's name. It's like Fran. Something really uptight. Fran. Thinking about you sending a dick picture. Who the is this? It's Vincent? With the ellipses and the question mark, I feel like that's the face people make after they send it. It's Vincent. I don't know any Vincents. Also, I showed this to all my friends and they laughed. And she sends a picture of her friends all going like this. Dude, you got a tiny dick. Your dick is so small that she literally covered it up with a mustache. I want to be more than friends. You mean best friends? No, more. Oh my God, mega best friends? Yeah! Way to shut that down. Speaking of shutting that down, ha ha ha, that's funny. I wasn't even wearing makeup today. Well, hey, they have good taste at least. I know, right? Yup, so how's your day going, beautiful? I hate that too. I hate the colon and the pee. Why'd that sound dirty? It's good. Do you need me to walk you back? Walk me back? Back to the friend zone you just tried to escape from. Oh, just shutting it down. Good job. Good job. Don't try to slide in the you're beautiful or you're gorgeous or you're attractive at the end of how's it going. That's one thing I hate so much. How's it going, gorgeous? Get out of here. Leave now. In the comment section down below, share your rejection stories. I think that'll be fun to read, for me at least, and for some of you guys as well. So go down in the comment section and let me know if you guys been rejected or if you've done the rejecting and what happened. Here's some more of my content. Great video here and a decent video here. I'm not gonna oversell it. It's a decent video. I love you guys. Have a great rest of your day.